Welcome, welcome, welcome back to Kinnundo. I am Kinnundo. Doctor Who is returning and I am so excited. So excited that I decided to copy Totally Not Mark and Yellow Apocalypse. I hope they don't mind, not that they're ever going to see this video. Basically, because I love Doctor Who, I'm going to watch all the episodes again and review them in 10 words or less. I'm also going to take their grading system and give them a score out of 10. Negative scores are ironic enjoyment and a zero is just... I'd like to say that this is my opinion. None of this is empirical fact. Feel free to disagree if you want, but now, let's get into it. Allons-y! Poor CGI, but a really good first episode. Beware, the trampoline with a face. Interesting concept, good execution, decent episode. Hot damn, this episode is so much fun! And it got even better! Stunning performance by Eccleston, and a great reintro to Daleks. Hey, Simon Pegg's in this one. And he's not funny. Emotional episode, but nothing more to it. Terrifying, hilarious, intriguing, a great part one.
No, I'm not your mummy! Get away from me! Ah!
This episode is just funny. They shouldn't have revealed the
spoilers
so soon. Deus ex machina done perfectly.
I'm the Doctor. You killed my father. Prepare to die.
Piper and Tennant impersonating Wanamaker makes this episode worth it. How did they make space werewolves boring? Watch the Sarah Jane Adventures on CBBC. A quotable, hilarious, adorable episode. Great designs, great social commentary, great music, great acting. Great. Brutal. The villain is a television. Wow. Okay, this is the best episode so far. Infinite creative potential, and they go with discount Beelzebos devil.
This sucks so bad.
The villain is a lonely child with a space bug infestation. Some of Tennant's best work as the Doctor. I don't not cry at this episode. Incredible. Everything about this episode is hilarious. Pretty good first episode for a great companion. Shakespeare plus witches plus the Doctor equals hilarious. Slow, boring episode, but you can't skip it because plot. Why are there pig people? Okay, this was really interesting. Again, can't skip it because plot, and it sucks. Cool concept that got me excited for Chibnall's run.
John X. Jones is my OTP.
This episode is just beautiful. Start to finish. Do I even need to explain?
Holy shit, it's
spoilers!
It's actually
spoilers!
Incredible way to show off
spoilers
power. Guys, how did we forget how great season 3 was? All kinds of campy, and I love it. Ladies and gentlemen, the best companion of all time. Such a brilliant, character-driven episode.
Hey! Hey! Slavery's bad!
Fun-filled romp from the Potato Head Space Marines.
Santa ha! Santa ha! Santa ha! Santa ha! Santa ha!
Wow, I did not expect this to be so interesting. Doctor Who meets Agatha Christie plus a giant bee. Fantastic. I have not seen these episodes because I'm terrified, but my friend says they're amazing, so... points. Somehow both interesting and forgettable at the same time. Donna has never been better.
No! Not Harriet Jones, former Prime Minister!
Probably the best companion send-off ever. Campy Christmas filler starring steampunk Cyberman Jaegers. This is way funnier than it deserves to be.
Have you been drinking Mars water? Try Chapstick.
What a total load of garbage. Beautiful dialogue between Wilf and Doc that
I'm not crying!
No TARDIS, no screwdriver, no ducks, no problem. Child actors can't ruin a thought-provoking episode.
Hello, again, friend of a friend. I knew you when.
Hello, I'm Stephen Morfitt. Welcome to How to Ruin Lore. Why was this a two-parter? I just love the title. I really fucking hate this boring-ass episode. Not as good as 42, but still not bad. Wait, what?
You killed Rory?
The last 10 minutes get a 10. It's a guilty pleasure, okay? Stephen, are we ever gonna use these costumes again?
Yes.
The most wibbly-wobbly, timey-wimey episode yet. Dumbledore hates cloudfish and loves opera. Why not? Okay, color me intrigued. Raises more questions than it answers.
Arrrrr!
This is just a dumbass filler Blue Peter prize. Interesting episode. Can they stick the landing? No.
No, they cannot. Ugh, I've got Lazarus flashbacks. Pretty incredible episode, and they reveal River! How does an episode with that title suck so much?
Dolls are not scary!
Interesting concept, boring execution, heartbreaking ending. God damn, this episode is actually really good! Again, guilty pleasure. Just campy, ridiculous fun featuring Stormageddon. I'm still confused. And where are the Father's Day Reapers?
Female means strong. Male means weak. PPC are feminists.
Why does this episode exist?
Why is Arthur Weasley in Doctor Who? Why is this such a fun episode?
Interesting look into the companions' lives, but what a cop-out. The last 5 minutes saved this from being a zero. Psychic Snow. Yeah, okay. Swing and a miss for social commentary. Doctor Who.
The musical.
The Doctor spends 45 minutes calling a Martian an Uber. Oh, so Clara can actually be good? Good. Dumb title, but surprisingly clever episode.
Oh my god, this is so dumb. Oh my god, it got dumber. Thank god it got better.
Okay, this is the best episode yet. I love it.
Wow, what a finale!
Goodbye, Matt Smith. Hey, remember the girl in the fireplace? Me too. Man, Capaldi hit his stride quickly. It just says vomit. Oh, right. Please don't tell me this season's gonna yo-yo. Now You See Me, in theaters, May 2013. I know people like this, but I just... don't. Perfect introduction for a new Doctor Who fan. This is just well written.
Maybe pollution isn't so bad.
Oh my god. Oh my god!
Oh my god.
Doctor Who, directed by Edgar Wright and Ridley Scott. Interesting episode, but slow and tonally iffy. Davros is an idiot in this.
Damn, the tension!
Some of the best monster design I've ever seen. Shit. Shit. Color me intrigued, I suppose. That's speech. Need I say more? Dumb villains, but a well-executed concept.
No, not Clara. She was my favorite.
The best episode Capaldi's ever been in. What a great series finale. Too childish, but great performances from Capaldi and Kingston. Hey look, it's the Great Sayer Man. Ha, get it? Because pilot episode? Not as bad as I feared from the trailer.
No.
Haven't we done the sentient tree thing before?
Holy shit, this is how you do Doctor Who.
Okay, Moffat, you have my curiosity. I mean, I'm still interested, I guess. Imagine what this could have been.
God save our gracious queen, long live our noble queen.
Besed will agus begin yon saich.
Holy shit! Holy shit! Holy shit! Holy shit!
Welcome aboard the TARDIS, Mrs. Whittaker. And there we go. That's all 144 episodes of Doctor Who, not including comic relief specials, reviewed in 10 words or less. But you don't want to go through all those again to find my favorites, do you? So I'm going to list my top 5 most and least favorite episodes right here, right now. Fifth worst. Love and Monsters is the room of Doctor Who. It's terrible, don't get me wrong. The acting's terrible, the CGI's terrible, the writing is terrible, the Absorbaloff looks terrible. But it's just the right kind of terrible, you know? This is definitely a guilty pleasure of mine. I know it sucks, but I love it because of that. It's only here because I think there'd be riots in the street if a worst Doctor Who episode's listicle did not contain this episode. Watch Mojo know, man. Watch Mojo always knows. Fifth best. Mummy on the Orient Express. Whenever someone tells me that they haven't seen Doctor Who and they want to get into it, I always say, watch Mummy on the Orient Express. This episode is fantastic, from the mummy's design, to Clara actually being a good character, to the twists and turns, and even a stellar performance from Frank Skinner of all people. This episode has everything Doctor Who should be, and sheds the weight of overarching stories, making it a perfect self-contained episode that I love going back to time and time again. Fourth worst.
The Doctor, the Widow, and the Wardrobe is clearly cashing in on the nostalgia that Whovians have for watching or reading the Chronicles of Narnia. It also does a terrible, terrible job of it, hammering you in the face with an anti-war, anti-deforestation, and anti-male message. Don't believe me? The sophisticated sentient tree people use their psychic powers to give a woman the power to save her husband from the war because she is a woman. And apparently woman means strong while man means weak. Come on, guys! We had a believable, well-written pansexual in 2005. How have we fallen so far when it comes to portraying feminism? Fourth best. Heaven Sent is one of the only episodes with only the Doctor throughout most of it. We get to see Capaldi doing what he did best as the Doctor, monologuing and working out things lightning fast, slowly piecing everything together in his mind. He really shines in this episode in a way that really makes you see why he was cast as the Doctor. Third worst. The Lazarus Experiment is just awful. The performances are awful, but the bad kind of awful. The plot is trash, the CGI is terrible, and they beat the villain the same way they beat Venom in Spider-Man 3. Yeah, they copied the worst Spider-Man movie for this. Did you know that Spider-Man 3 came out the day before this shitty episode? Man, 2007 sucked. But the worst part of all this is that you can't skip this episode, because it's important to the overarching plot of the series. Not much, but you still need to know about it. God, I hate this obnoxious episode. Third best. Do I need to explain why literally every Doctor Who fan loves Blink? It's one of the most suspenseful, well-written, well-designed, terrifying episodes that I've ever seen from any TV show. The Weeping Angels are horrifying monsters that always make me second-guess where I walk in case a statue zaps me back to the 40s. This episode is so amazing that Moffat made three more Weeping Angel episodes in the next few years. Granted, they all suck major ass, but still. The Angels top a lot of best villain lists, and that is all because of Blink. What a cultural icon for Whovians. Second worst. Nothing fucking happens in Amy's Choice. Moving on. Second best. The Impossible Planet. This is the perfect Doctor Who episode. Strip him of his power, put him in a confined space within an intimidating backdrop, and slowly build the tension to the final villain, an entity who the Doctor knows nothing of. This episode is amazing. The Ood looks spectacular. The set design is amazing. The Beast is awesome. The characters are memorable and diverse. The Black Hole is breathtaking. I find literally nothing wrong with this episode. And if that's how I feel about the runner-up, imagine how I'm gonna be for the best. Worst. The End of Time Part 2 is a beautiful send-off to my favorite Doctor. It has moments of palpable emotion, incredible writing and line delivery, and some of the most beautiful music that the show has ever seen. Unfortunately, it's all fucking ruined by part one. Sweet merciful God, I hate this episode so much. It's hammy, it's boring, it's offensive to the characters. This episode involves awful-looking cactus people, a guy who wants to make his daughter immortal and entrusts a genocidal maniac with the job. They bring back John Sims' master, which you think would be good, but nope. They give him lightning powers, an insatiable appetite, and he occasionally turns into Skeletor. And then he turns everyone on the planet into him, because immortality and fucking transfiguration are so intrinsically linked, aren't they? Even the Doctor sucks in this. He seems like he's just going through the motions. And then, on top of all of this, they shoehorn in the Time Lords making a fucking prophecy, and they explain the Master's mind drumming. Okay. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure nobody fucking asked to know about that. Wasn't the drumming just meant to signify that the Master was, you know, insane? Wasn't that the point? Dear God, this episode was one hell of a low point for the series. Luckily, I know just the episode to make it all better. And that is... The Best. The Day of the Doctor is not just an hour-long episode. It's a love letter to the entire series. You can tell that everyone involved was completely amazed by what they were doing, what they had achieved. Everything about this episode is just spectacular. Smith has some of his best work here, Tennant returns with a stunning performance, John Hurt weighs in with a heartbreaking and incredible portrayal of a Doctor who is ravaged by war and suffering. The Zygons are an interesting and brilliant villain, and I for one am glad that the main antagonists are from the original run of the show, and aren't the Daleks or the Cybermen. Billy Piper returns as the Bad Wolf in a fantastic performance, and we finally see the Time War up close after so many years of wondering. Day of the Doctor is the kind of episode that always reminds me why I love this show, why I always come back to it no matter how bad it gets. Because at its heart, Doctor Who is just a TV show about a madman with a box. And that's all it really needs to be. But it goes so much further. It pushes the limits of expectation. It dives into questions of war, hate, love, revenge, forgiveness, peace, and freedom. Doctor Who has undeniably shaped me as a person, and I can't wait to see where it goes next. Thank you for watching to the end. If you enjoyed, please consider liking or sharing this video, and subscribe if you want to see more content. Thank you all, and I will see you next time. Bye!